How are you, Dalvin?
I'm doing good, Rich.
All right, let's talk about it right in there. How's that shoulder doing?
It's doing good. It's getting better. It's not getting worse, so that's good news.
Okay, that is good. That's right. So is it an old injury? I mean, walk us through how this cropped up against Seattle a couple of weeks ago.
Nah, it happened before our bye week when we played Denver. I kind of fell on the wrong, but I've been standing it hard with treatment and those guys. I just got a little banged up in the Seattle game, and they just hold me out for precautions. That was it.
Okay. Well, I mean, how does it manifest itself? Do you lose feeling? Does it tingle? I mean, what's the sensation you get when this acts up, Dalvin?
Yeah, anybody with a shoulder injury could tell you. It's just about the way you land. You know, you're going to brace for contact. You're going to take contact. You're going to learn how to, you know, take care of yourself in certain situations. But it's just all about how you land. And I think I've been doing – I did a great job in Detroit of, you know, being conscious of how I land and take those hits.
And yet the hits is essentially been you doling them out this year. Just a tremendous year number three for you. What would you say to those evaluating you back in the combine and draft? What would you say to those folks right now that might not have – thought this possible, Dalvin?
I just think if you did, you know, you really didn't watch the tape too hard, or you didn't really, you know, watch me play. But I just love playing football, and I think the Vikings knew that once they drafted me. I'm all about playing football, and that's what I love to do on a daily basis. So, you know, I got love for the game, and that's all I knew growing up. So playing football is what I love to do, and, you know, like I said, going through the process, you could kind of be misunderstood, but the Vikings took the time out to know who Dalvin was, and that's why I'm here in Minnesota.
Yeah, I mean, I guess that's also what I was driving at as well, was you being misunderstood and what was going on with you outside of the football world, and clearly none of that is an issue for you as a professional. What would you say about that part of everything now year three for you?
I'm just glad I got that behind me and glad I, you know, got a chance to come to this great organization so I could really show, you know, the Vikings fans and people around the world and this organization, you know, that I'm all about playing ball and all about winning football games. And I'm here to, you know, show who Dalvin is really off the field. And I've been getting in the community and doing things and just showing my face and showing who I really am.
Who has believed in you the most, do you think, there in Minnesota, Dalvin?
This whole organization, you know, like you said, I went down my first year. I was banged up last year. And these guys, everybody around here, been behind my back 1,000%, you know, just making sure I get healthy to get on the field.
Well, what was difficult about that mostly then, being hurt and not being able to play like the guy that we're seeing this year?
Yeah, mentally, it can drain you. You know, you're waking up, you're just going to treatment every day instead of focusing on football. And that can take a toll on your mind and, you know, how you look at this thing. But for me, I just kind of stayed ground. Like I said, the circle I had around me with my family and, you know, the people here at the Vikings, you know, they kept my mind, you know, where I needed to be at. And I was getting healthy, and I was able to do that so I could be, you know, where I'm at today.
Dalvin Cook, just the third Vikings player with 13 or more rushing touchdowns over the first 13 games of a season, joining Chuck Foreman and Adrian Peterson in that regard right here on the Rich Eisen Show. What does that mean to hear a stat like that thrown at you?
I met AP. I met Chuck. I sat down with Chuck for lunch. Two great individuals off the field, but on the field, you know, they play, speak for themselves. So to be mentioned with those guys, it's a great honor and, you know, something that can't be taken away.
What'd you take away from that lunch with Chuck Foreman, Dalvin Cook? What was that like?
A lot of knowledge. He's just been telling me, you know, how the game has evolved since he's been playing. And, you know, just telling me, you know, the hard work can outweigh anything. So just always be ready for any situation and don't let the opportunity be too big. And that's why I'm always ready for, you know, every opportunity.
So did either of you kind of dead leg when the bill came? What happened? What happened then?
We kind of had the whole running back group, so, you know, the young guys got to pay for it.
Okay. That's where the stiff arm happened? Is that what you're saying?
That's when I hit the spin move.
Man, I bet so. Now, early on in the season, I'm not telling any tales out of school. It seemed that the offense wasn't performing. Clearly, it wasn't performing as well as it has since about week four, week five. Some of the wide receivers were very vocal in this department. What happened to have the light go on here, Dalvin Cook?
I think everybody was men about the situation. There was teammates about the situation, and I think we handled the situation as great as anybody could handle the situation. Everybody voiced their opinion, got what they needed to get off their chest, and we moved on from it. We worked towards what everybody, what everybody's opinion was. So if Diggs had an opinion, Adam had an opinion, we worked towards it, we got better at it, and I think that's what made us the offense. We are today. So we clicking, and we just got to keep going.
And, at one point, Cousins seemed to apologize publicly for his role in all of this. Was that necessary, do you think?
I think on his part, if he needed to get it off his chest, so be it. As a quarterback, you hold yourself to a high standard, and I know Kirk do, because I see him work on a daily basis. So he knows the throws he missed that he can make in his sleep, that he can make those throws, and he make them on a daily. So I think that's why he apologized, because he knows he can make those throws.
And did this bring you together? I mean, did that sort of, in a way, need to happen in order to see the success that we have witnessed most of the time in the last 10 weeks almost?
Yeah, it definitely did. Like I said, it's just guys holding each other responsible, and I think that's what a brother is, holding the next guy responsible. And that's what we was doing, just holding each other responsible, and I think that's what got us over that hump.
Well, look, Dalvin Cook, I mean, obviously Mike Zimmer is a guy who does not suffer fools gladly at all, and the last thing he's going to want to suffer is a trip to a 5-win spot and everybody's looking over the steering wheel and seeing a Monday nighter against Green Bay that's a must-have. What are you guys talking about in that regard to avoid a trap against the Chargers here this weekend, Dalvin?
Lock in on this game plan. We know we got Green Bay next week, Monday night, primetime game. But that's something we can't control until we get there Monday night. So the Chargers, they got great athletes, great team, a lot of guys returning from injury. So we got to take this team serious. And we kind of look back at the Denver game. That was kind of like our wake-up call with a team that not have as good of a record that we kind of took lightly at first. So we had to play from behind. I don't think we want that feeling again. So we're going to take these guys very strong, and we're going to go in there and lock in on the game plan and be ready to play.
All right, and you are aware, I mean, this is not me. I couldn't get you. I drafted too low. You do realize the amount of fantasy hopes that are being placed in you. It's the playoffs already this weekend. Are you aware of that, Dalvin?
This fantasy football stuff crazy, but it can't go unnoticed. Like my family and stuff have me on their fantasy, and they be texting me about it.
Wait a minute. What? Say that again? What?
It's funny, man. The fantasy world is funny, man. It's funny.
So your family members have drafted you, and they're not talking about, hey, Chargers this, Packers that. They're talking about their fantasy team, and you've got to come through for them. Is that fact?
Yeah, that's how I go. That fantasy stuff is serious.
Okay. So you are, in other words, aware it's playoff time and already?
I'm aware of it.
Okay. What are your thoughts on Florida State and the hiring of Mike Norvell, Dalvin Cook? What do you think about this?
Since we hired him, I've been seeing the press clips and the information he's been giving out of how he want to approach the situation. And I just think, I think he has a great idea, and I think he's a good coach, what he's been doing for Memphis. So I think it was the right hire, and we just got to get this thing back turned around and where we wanted to go.
Well, I was pounding the table for Deion, being the coach.
Yeah, that wouldn't have been a bad idea. Deion knows how to recruit. He knows the tradition and the culture of Florida State, and I think it's all about getting back to playing Florida State football in the way they need to play it.
Hey, Dalvin, I appreciate the time. Let's chat real soon again. Good luck against the Chargers, and then for your family in their fantasy finals or semifinals. And we'll chat again real soon.
All right.
You got it. That's Dalvin Cook. Vikings running back.
For more of the Rich Eisen Show, tune to Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV for free on BR Live or download the Rich Eisen Show app.